It was written in the stars. I saw it dance in the heavens. We'd be waving from our cars. But as the moon kissed the sun in a celestial embrace, we found ourselves still grounded, stuck in the same old ways. All the rapture didn't happen, but the party was divine. We danced beneath the shadow with our life.
Welcome, welcome, welcome one, welcome all, welcome big, welcome small, Boulder Talk Radio, post-rapture edition, folks. We were told it was going to happen. People out there claiming that they knew the date, they knew the time, they knew the end was coming, it was here. Waited around all damn day, was hoping to see something, you know, hoping to see something miraculous happen. But apparently it didn't happen. Apparently, not even Goatsy. I had to edit this to make it work. I tried so hard to get this to work with freaking AI all day. I just wanted a Goatsy meme. And I think it worked. I think we did good. We did good on the Goatsy. The whole thing. Spherical Mania says, I was worthy. I got raptured. I'm commenting from the great Jurassic Park in the sky. That's fantastic. It's fantastic. Music Man says, I was waiting for a dragon or some shit. Exactly. You know, you keep hoping for a dragon. You keep hoping for something. Astro here says, I love these opening songs. Yeah, I tried. I was listening to like some B-52s. And then I asked GPT to write me a funny rock song. And then I just like had Suno kind of do it like in a bit of a post-punk, like new waves, like 80s style. And I thought it worked out pretty well. You know, I thought it was pretty good. I like the opening songs. Yeah. I do too. Let's see. Mo here says Cody Rhodes winning last night is what delayed the rapture. Cody winning his story made a lot of men cry. That is very true. You know, a lot of men, very upset. Happy. I'm sorry. I don't want to mean upset. I mean, very happy. Tears crying down their face. Going up to President Trump, telling him how happy they are that Cody won. Anyway, CJH here asking, does this mean we can sin as much as we want? Now, I mean, sin. Well, in the eyes of God. And I remember this from when I went to school, when I went to Sunday school, and when I actually was religious. The only sin that is non-forgivable, apparently, is blasphemy. Everything else, apparently, is fair game. All right? Everything else is apparently fair game. Like it's like the purge, but you just can't do that one thing, right? You murder someone, repent, apologize, take Jesus' name into your heart. You are forgiven, you know? Rape someone, same concept. Assault children. Become a predator of children. Same concept. Okay. Lie, cheat, steal, destroy private goods, covet thy neighbor's wife, don't respect your parents, cheat on your taxes, jaywalk, don't pay your car insurance, steal a candy bar. All of it's A-okay, but goddamn it, you can't say goddamn. Goddamn it, you can't say goddamn. Did anyone tell you that Alex Jones was a special guest referee for the match last night? What? No. I'm sure I would have heard about that. We are the people that are left behind. Yeah, the 8 billion of us. That's who was left behind. I mean, if you think about it, if you think about it, like the Jehovah's Witnesses make the claim that like 110,000 people will be raptured, you know? So out of 8 billion people, would we really miss 110,000 if they're the ones that are taken? You know, like, I'm going to kind of disappear. On average, how many people die a day? There we go. Okay. On average, there are about 150,000 deaths every single day. Roughly 2/3 of those deaths, so 100,000 deaths, are caused by age-related causes. Okay, so 150,000 people a day die. How many Jehovah's Witnesses go to heaven? That's my question. According to Wikipedia, Jehovah's Witnesses believe that only 144,000 faithful Christians will be resurrected to heaven as immortal spirit beings to spend eternity with God in Christ. So think about that for a second. Think about that. 150,000 people die every single day in the world. 150,000 people. Jehovah's Witnesses claim that only 144,000 people will ascend to heaven. The rest are just going to die. Crazy, right? Crazy to think about that. Crazy to think about. Fun, but crazy. Anyway, we've survived the rapture. We've survived it all. CJHer says, I've actually thought about if the people who died suddenly are way too young are technically the ones that were raptured. And then I snap back to reality. I mean, I was watching one of those like Christian channels when I was a teenager. And I remember like they had a bit where Jesus is sitting there with a whole bunch of children who were like all aborted, you know, but these kids are like 5 or 6 years old. So clearly not physical manifestations of aborted fetuses. Otherwise, it would just be like a bunch of test tubes and clumps of cells and shit. You know, that's what it would be. And then Jesus is all like, you know, one little girl is all like, Jesus, why did my mama abort me? And he's all like, I can't tell you that, but I know that your mother loved you. Jesus, what would I have been if I would have been alive? Well, my child, you would have cured cancer. Like, fucking tells this 5-year-old girl, you would have cured cancer. Like, that's a big fucking burden to put on a kid. Even in this case, a dead kid, you know, because now that dead kid's got fucking FOMO, right? Now that dead kid's going to sit around eternity going like, I'm just a fucking aborted clump of cells, but I could have cured cancer. Well, God damn it. What are the chances of the resurrection, you know, God, what's it called? Reincarnation, right? And it's just like, no, you would have done that. Let's see. John here says, your pretty face is going to hell, makes a mockery of religion. It's funny, can't be 15 minutes fun. Is your pretty face a person or is that me? I don't know. How many would have become crooks and murderers? Ooh. I mean, see, now you're getting into some stuff we're not going to dive into, Parallax, because that would require some data that I don't necessarily believe. It would require some data. And no matter how you spin it, you would end up like, it would sound bad. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm like, you know what I mean, right? It'd be like, where are the highest rates of abortion take place? Some could ask, you know, oh, your pretty face is an Adult Swim show. Okay. I don't have cable television, so I don't know what that is. I'm behind on so much stuff these days, guys. You have no idea. I feel bad, but at the same time, you know, it is what it is, right? I can't really do much about it. You know, I have to, I have things to do. I got, you know, I set up LED lights today for my children in their bedroom because my daughter was all like, I want LED lights. And I said, okay, I got her a pair and I put them up, you know, and then my daughter brought home a middle school aged book that her teacher wants the parents to read to the kids, 15 chapters or so a week. We went through 15 chapters in about 35, 40 minutes tonight. So we're already ahead of the curve on our reading assignment. Anyway, let's see. Adult Swim puts all their shit online. One of the reasons why, yeah, they do. But I mean, here's the thing. If you don't know about it, that's what I'm talking about. If I don't get the details, if I don't get that information, then I don't know. I don't know what it is, man. There's so much that's going on. You know, I spent most of the day trying to figure out how to get AI to make a Goatsy meme out of a goddamn eclipse. You know how hard that was? Like, I legitimately made like reference images. The amount of time I spent just trying to make it work, I probably could have gone and actually drawn it myself. It's pretty bad. Okay. So, you know, and if I'm out there trying to make Goatsy memes, I'm not paying attention to what's happening on Adult Swim. So there we go on that one. Oh my God. What else has been going on today? I know there is some movie stuff that happened. I thought about bringing back like Hollywood After Dark as like the 30-minute podcast. It's just tough, man. It's just tough, you know? So it's kind of like, I don't have the time right now. Like, as soon as my girlfriend goes back to work, or she's not home when I get home with the kids, I have time to work. Otherwise, we share the computer and it just ends up like, you know, cutting into my work time. That's not her fault. She's trying to find work. So you ate the fish. I don't know what the fuck that is. Jesus is woke, confirmed. We know Jesus is woke. That's what I don't get. All these right wingers that are just like, Jesus would be against trans ideology. God only made the man and the woman. Yeah, but you're like, bro, fucking, there's been billions upon billions upon billions of people. All right. Surely there's going to be like different people, you know, certain things are going to get crossed in the development process. Not that it's a bad thing, right? But if, like, you know, God can have a baby born without an arm, then God can have a person born in the wrong body. I'm just saying it can happen. Jesus hung out with the hookers. I mean, dude, he was probably nailing them hookers, man. He was probably nailing them hookers. I would hope so. If Jesus wasn't hooking up with Mary Magdalene, you know, like, that would be pretty funny. That'd be pretty funny. You know, could you just imagine he comes home from a long day of like turning water into wine and he's like, oh God. Oh, sorry, Father. I don't mean to take your name in vain. This has been such a fucking day. And then Mary Magdalene's there. She's just like wiping the cum off her fucking mouth. You know, I just got home from work too, Jesus. What do you want to do? And he's like, I don't know. I'm so worked up. I'm so tense. You know, I've been working these hands all day. She's like, oh, tell me about it. Cheers. Right. And he's like, yeah, but it's just my back, my knees, my head. Everything is so just, ugh. You know, and then she's like, well, here, let me take care of you. So she's like, you know, rubbing him. And then she fucking sucks his dick. And then, like, he fucking nuts. And then he feels better. And he's like, then he can go to sleep. They didn't have fucking, you know, melatonin back then. Right. They had wine. You could drink wine till you blacked out. You know, get that fermented shit, fuck you up, right? But they also had blowjobs, and they knew what blowjobs could accomplish, you know? So she took in the body of Christ, literally. Literally. Does he fucking say his name when he comes? Like, that's my question. Oh, Jesus, ah, oh, me, ah, oh, me, ah, oh, ah. Oh. what I love about doing this show and talking all the trash I do about everything is people get really mad at me for it. They do. They get really, really, really mad at me. And that's okay. It's part of the fun, folks. It's part of everything that that needs to happen. Let's see. What do we got here? What? There's what's this? Hold on. I'm looking. Apparently I'm just kind of like rolling through. Ow. Now I'm like rolling through Reddit trying to find some interesting, you know, crazy TikToks to look at. And it's all this one. It's all like, we've seen demons. And you're like, yeah. And then it's like, it's a written post. Like, I don't want no written post, motherfucker. Give me crazy, crazy, crazy TikTok. Those are always fun. But, you know, here's the thing. NASA sent off 3 rockets today. Apparently CERN fired off some stuff. And then from there, you know, I mean, we're still here. No massive earthquakes, nothing that's really happened. It's just crazy stuff. You know, we're all fine. We're all here enjoying another episode of Boulder Talk Radio, which is, you know, whatever I do here. I'm not even too sure sometimes, to be honest with you. It's like we do some shit. We just talk, right? We just talk. The Giant of Kandahar. What do you want me to, like, say about the Giant of Kandahar? I've talked about that. It's just a fucking rumor. Do you want me to watch a video on? Is that what's going on? CJHer says, dinosaurs never died and evolved into reptilians and greys. I don't think they evolved into the greys. I mean, but there's definitely some, you know, like alligators, right? Cockroach has been around a long ass time. Spherical Man says, except we don't know yet what CERN may have wiped or switched from our reality. I mean, that is true. Here's the thing. If in the next 6 months, we all of a sudden start seeing a larger slew of Mandela effect comments popping up, then maybe, just maybe, that's what happened. All right. Reed here says, I'm here just wrote my first song of a songwriting project for writing a song a day. That's very cool, man. I just played a song that I made with AI like in 5 minutes. So there I am. But I know, I wish you well on that one. And yeah, birds are related to dinos. That's correct. Mo here says, CERN bioengineer Jank from TYT. Yeah. Well, I mean, Jank is still around, right? Someone here did a video on Reddit. Eclipse conspiracies are a masterclass in idiotic buffoonery. That is true. But what we want to watch is some crazy ones, okay? So I'm trying to find like crazy. This is what I'm saying, man. It's like fucking the craziness that comes out of some of those TikToks are fun to find. I just don't know where to find them. You know, I just don't know where to find them. There's, if you guys got anything, we'll take a look at it, right? Because there's a lot of wild shit. Last night was fun. So I'm just looking through the conspiracy theory subreddit to see if there's anything there. Nothing I necessarily think is too interesting. I understand that there's like UFO. There's apparently UFO shit that was seen today. Let me see if I can find that. Because there was something about UFOs that I saw pop up, right? People were like, did you see what happened? Did you see what happened today with all this shit? Let's see. Trying to find it there. Okay, well, yeah, we can take a look here at some footage of the, you know, of the eclipse. Let me see. Get that right there. I got to prop it. I got to, you know, do my thing. Got to get it up. Well, I mean, I don't really have any trouble on that department there, guys. Okay, let's see here. Is there sound? Okay, so this is NASA from Mazatlan, right? What they saw from Mazatlan. Look at that. Look at those flares, right? Look at the flaring of that. Just coming out from over top. I mean, it's a pretty magical thing, to be fair. It's a pretty magical thing. It definitely is like, when I was at the totality in 2017, that was pretty cool. That was pretty cool. I really enjoyed that when I was there. That's it. That's all they got. There's gotta be more footage than that. I'm gonna find more footage. Cause that's like, it's cool. Wait, is it replaying? Yeah, we're just fine. It can replay while I'm looking. It's just, I won't put the sound on. Okay. What do we got here? Because there's apparently some other video footage of like what appears to be an alien. I don't know. Someone said they saw something. It's 11 seconds long. All right. Here, take a look at this. Get that up there.
What was that?
Okay.
What was that?
Yo, what the fuck?
Aliens.
Yo.
Okay, do y'all see anything? Let's watch again from the beginning.
Bruh.
Oh, there it is.
What was that? What the fuck was that?
Yo, what the fuck?
Aliens.
Yo.
So, right there where you can see something. It's probably an airplane.
Bruh.
Look, there's something flying through the air.
I mean, it's probably an airplane, but these people are believing that it is. You didn't see shit. It's kind of difficult. It is kind of if TikTok is a different dimension. Yeah, it is. It is, but it's fun. Also, Parallax, yes, I saw Fallout's getting released at 6 p.m. on Wednesday night, which is awesome because I have Wednesday off, and so I will be watching a lot of Fallout that night. I think it's going to be pretty cool. You didn't see shit. You got to look. It's up by where I see it. It's up by here. We're going to just scroll back. Okay. So see, can you see my control where the mouse cursor is? Like right there. It looks like a sliver. And then you can see it moving through this cloud bank area. But I think it looks like a shadow of a plane.
Look, there's something flying through the air.
Yeah, it's just like, that's all it is. It's really not like much, you know? So, you know, I'll have to wait and see on that one. But yeah, let me see if there's anything else here that popped up today. A lot of people are talking about, you know, what they saw and everything. Okay, so apparently, here we go. Here we go. So here's some shit coming in from Reddit today. Believe what you will. You know, I always like to put it out there like that. These are kind of crazy. Okay, what we've got here are three videos from Italy, Peru, and others. Three videos from others. Where's others specifically? Clear video footage of a UFO. Clear video footage of a UFO. This is filmed in Italy. Clear footage of a video UFO. Peru. Quickly passed by a plane. Okay, so this is what somebody is saying. All right. Again, it's always fucking shit goddamn quality, you know. Even though it's here in 1080p. Although this, you know, fortunately, StreamYard can't do 1080p unless I pay for it. So here's what we know. What is this? Is this
welcome to the UFO video footage series?
Okay, AI. It's all AI.
This exciting UFO was filmed in Italy, but published in the United States by researcher Paula Harris during the 36th International MUFON Symposium 2005 in Denver, Colorado. Watch the video and tell me what you think.
That's CG. That's fake. God damn it. That's fake. That's fake. You can tell. Here we go. Same one. Minute to know.
Welcome to the UFO video footage series. An interesting sighting of a ring-shaped UFO, filmed in Cusco, Peru in April 2020. Watch the video and tell me what you think.
Again, it's shot through a potato. What is that? I don't know. But I mean, we have no other frame of reference for what it is. So I don't think it's anything. I mean, they're awfully calm for what it might be. I don't know. All right, here we go. This is apparently.
Welcome. This video is widely circulated, and I have seen it on many social media sites. Those who believe it is real claim that it is a leak from NASA and secrets that have not been revealed. But after a long search, it turned out that this video is fake and that this plane is Russian and flying at high altitudes. There is original, clean, high-quality video that has been obviously edited. Watch the video and tell me what you think.
All right, you can hear it a little bit as it went by, as the two ships went by, you could hear a little bit of a disturbance. With that in mind, watch this. See how that happened?
Okay, so something went by there. You know, this shit's probably, again, potato quality. Peru has no stars. It's not that Peru doesn't have any stars, Iwan. What it is that, like, the quality of the camera is going to focus on, like, it's an auto, right? They had the camera in auto. So when the camera is in automatic, what it does is it highly focuses on the whites, like the brightest color it can. So it's not going to have the depth of field or the quality or the megapixels to be able to pick up what's beyond it. If the guy would have had like a decent DSLR or fuck dude, any kind of like, you know, camera that's like maybe modern, it would have been able to, Let's see. CJHU says apparently they have all the 4K footage, but they're not allowed to share it. Yeah, whatever, man. Whatever. You gotta love it. You gotta love it here. Let's see. Oh, what do you know? Okay, Colbert talked about it. We'll see how this goes, because this is going to get clipped so fucking bad. But we'll see how it goes.
Welcome, everybody, to The Late Show. I'm your host, Stephen Colbert. And I just want to start off today by saying happy Eclipse Day. I'm so glad to see all of you here in the Ed Sullivan Theater, because it means that my eclipse glasses worked. And then my retinas are still intact.
By the way, funny thing about that. One of the top Googled searches today is, why do my eyes hurt after looking at an eclipse, after looking at the sun? I don't get it. You can warn people. You can tell people constantly, hey, don't look at the sun. And they're like, okie dokie, artichoke. And then they fucking look at the goddamn sun. Anyway.
And I need those retinas for important stuff, like staring at my phone at 3 o'clock in the morning. Everybody see it? Everybody get a chance to see it today? Amazing. That's it? It's an amazing thing to see. Here at The Late Show, we moved up rehearsal so we could all go outside and watch. And as beautiful and otherworldly as eclipses are, there is a simple scientific explanation. For a brief moment, the dread god Telebrion devours Mother Moon to punish gentle Talaoth, the man within. That's why we always ring the bell of noontime darkness to frighten Telebrion back into the horn of dusk.
Wow. Sorry, hold on here. John says, Christian rubes love to be blinded by the light. Yeah, basically, man. It's, to me, it's really funny, though. It's just that it's like so many people want this shit to be real. They'll manifest it. Command Unit here for Two Bones. Thank you. Says the rapture happened. No one was worthy. I mean, there's got to be some worthy people out there, right? There's got to be some worthy people. Is it not the Mormons? I believe it would be the Mormons. Not higher tier Mormons, lower tier Mormons. The flock of Mormons, they're generally nice people. Although those that engage in the polyamory, you know, the multiple wives situation is pretty funny. God, how would that work? That's got to be so wild. That's got to be so wild. You're like, it is my religion to have multiple wives and through them a lot of children. There's got to be some inbreeding that happens. There's got to be at some point in time. You're just going to like eventually just run out of womb, I guess. I don't know.
I learned all that from Neil deGrasse Tyson. A few lucky people got to experience today's eclipse from 30,000 feet because some airlines offered special flights to chase the eclipse path around the country. Okay, I mean, that sounds cool, but the windows are over here. Sun's up there. Even if the plane does barrel rolls, what if you're in the middle seat? Could you just lean back a little? Open the shade. No, okay, fine. Well, then I get to watch Napoleon. Of course, an eclipse is always a good opportunity to ponder our place amongst the stars. But it's also a great time to see your pets go crazy. In fact, scientists warned pet owners that their furry friends may exhibit strange behaviors. And I'm being told we have footage of one dog during the eclipse.
Out of my way!
It happens.
Fucking Shaggy dog, man. That's funny. That's old. Like, that's old Disney right there. That's an old ass Disney right there, man. Also, I agree with Paul here, Comic Binge. Having multiple wives sounds like hell. Yeah, man. Like, one is enough. I don't know how people do more than one. I don't get it. I don't understand it. It's like. You can't. I mean, the only way it works, right, is if you've got like, okay, so like in the multi-wife situation, you've got the mama-san, right? You got the head wife, the first wife, who keeps the other bitches in line because that's what she does, right? And then they all figure out a schedule to all spend time with the husband and they alternate, you know, who's doing what and what night. And the husband is just like, yeah, he works a lot, you know, and he has to like kind of maintain the fatherly stuff and whatever. But he gets his choice of like, different pussy like fucking three to four times a week. You know what I mean? Like, he's like, you know, the women are kind of starved for attention. He's out there going like, I'm just going to sleep with you one night. I'm going to sleep with you the next night. And I'm going to sleep with you the night after that. And then we're going to rotate out again, you know? And it's like most likely a fair amount of fucking. A fair amount of fucking. One is more than enough. Yeah. All right. Command unit here for two. Thank you. Says Napoleon film legit made me rage quit the theater. Really? Really? Because they just said that they're not going to be putting out the that they're not going to be putting out what's it called, the 4-hour director's cut, apparently. So that sucks ass. Also, command unit here, reminder about the corridor. That, yeah, I got it queued up. I do have it queued up. It's we're just on this shit for right now. So okay, let's get in. I don't want to keep getting booted, so let's figure it out.
That was happening. That was happening all over. Yeah. The line of totality. That's on the totality only. It's not just pets. Experts also said that most animals would likely be confused by the darkness and start their nighttime routines. Oh. Animals have nighttime routines? Watches the giraffe exfoliates with a water-based cucumber cleanser, while its predator, the lion, plugs in its CPAP machine. Oh, no. It forgot the distilled water. The eclipse started its trip across America down in Texas, and CNN announced the event with this chyron: animals at Dallas Zoo react to total solar eclipse. Thank you, CNN. That is news you can use. I wish they'd give more animal takes on current events. I want to see breaking ring-tailed lemur reacts to RFK Jr.'s VP pick. Okay, CNN, how did the animals react?
We started hearing like...
Okay, I want to get to like... strange behavior with people. All right, I don't know. I don't think we're gonna get anything out of this. Also, I don't want to fucking get myself clipped, because you know how they are, man. You know how they get, right? You know how it is, man. They come after you, man. You know they do. They do. They come after you. You fucking play CBS too much. Those old motherfuckers after your ass, constantly after your ass. oh, Jesus Christ. Anyway, what do we got here in regards? Is there anything good that's happening? That's anything? Is there any good videos? Anyone kind of freaked out a little bit? Because I'd like to see that. I'd like to see some weird videos. So I'm asking. I'm like legit asking here. If we know of anything. If not, that's cool too. All right. Parallax here says, yeah, screw the animals. We want to see the chuds go wild battling demons from the eclipse. Did I do a deep lore about Chris Benoit? I did a podcast about that, right? I'll show you guys what that is. I did it tonight. I'm trying to like get that back up and running too. So all I did, and it's not a deep, I mean, so here we go. I just put this up tonight. Three stories. It's like an overview of all three. You've got Benoit. You've got this woman over here on the left. She killed herself back in the 1970s on live television. She was a news anchor suffering depression. She was actually like worried about being childless and unwed by the age of 30. And then the other woman here is one who went missing, presumed dead. That's what that was. That's all it is. TikTok live at night is more weird. You know, I'm going to bring up the TikTok. I'm going to bring it up, because I just feel so much more interesting than YouTube half the fucking time. You know what I mean? But the question then becomes like, how do you find the good shit? You know? So we got to find some shit. All right. Well, cause, oh, I'll share the tab so y'all know what I'm looking at. That way it's not just like whatever. Let me on. Yeah, man. All right. Yeah, man. It's cool. I'll send you a link. All right. You know, while we're waiting for Paul, we'll check out a bit of that Corridor Digital video that Command Unit sent over, because I know he wants to, this is all again, you know, I talk about all the stuff that's going on with you know, with AI and shit. So was that what inspired the Joker movie scene? I would say it's probably other like suicides. This stream's going to become communist propaganda. Dun 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 dun. Is that the fucking? Is that the one? Right, that's the one, isn't it? I believe so. Hold on, I gotta find. There we go. It's not Paul Turman. God damn it, I fucked up. I'm so today's been weird. Why do you think your name was Paul? Anyway, I'm sorry.
I apologize. I didn't mean to do that. That's all a problem.
Okay.
Mr. Hankey says.
Do you ever feel like visual effects in old movies were better? What if I told you that wasn't just nostalgia speaking? Back in the 1960s, Disney invented a technology that was in many ways superior to the green screen. But that tech has long since been forgotten. And what if I told you that we found a way to recreate it?
Is it AI? I bet you it's AI.
Being able to layer one moving image over another is the fundamental building block of visual effects. Every single crazy effect shot from every movie you love relies on this basic core technique. And the primary way we do that is with green screen or blue screen. But there are lots of problems with green screen, even in this modern era. You can't film blurry or transparent things. You can't wear clothes that are the same color as the screen. And the spill of the color oftentimes ruins footage. If I want to make a movie about a clown wearing all the colors of the rainbow getting married on Mars, I can't. And that bothers me. If I could get my hands on an invention that didn't have any of these issues, it would be like a filmmaking superpower. It would be like magic.
Do you really think so?
What's special about that?
It's transparent.
It's transparent.
It's transparent.
I thought the stuff I was seeing on screen was impossible. They're keying a veil. They're keying salt, smoke. They're even wearing blue and green clothes. This movie from 1964 broke every rule of chroma keying, and they did it all without computers. So how do they do it? To explain the science behind the magic, we are joined by Dr. Paul Dubevic.
The sodium vapor process. Instead of a blue screen or a green screen, they used what was sometimes called a yellow screen. It was a very specific spectrum of yellow made from a low pressure sodium vapor light that puts out one wavelength of light at 589 nanometers. Because it's just one wavelength.
Checking out this video about
how dichroic filters work,
Disney
you can
technology.
Actually block just that
Sounds
one wavelength.
Fascinating.
Kinda. I mean, it's old school.
Or
it's old school
let
tech.
Just that one wavelength go through. So the magic of the sodium vapor process is they used a beam splitter prism so that the light that comes through the lens gets split onto two strips of film at the same time.
TikTok?
The sodium vapor wavelength
this is
589 nanometers reflects out this way, and all the rest of the spectrum goes through and can expose a color image of the actor. And that's exactly what you need to get your map. What's kind of magical about it is that you can block that one wavelength of yellow without messing up all of the other colors. In that scene, there's no matte lines. He's motion blurring, he's dancing around. The compositing is impeccable. You couldn't have gotten such great blur over the alpha channel with a green screen or a blue screen.
It seems too good to be true. Why are we not still using this technology today?
Yeah, really, what gives?
Because they were never able to replicate the prism. What?
I've read that Disney was only able to produce one prism. Is that true?
They had to join two pieces of glass and then have layers of material with different indices of refraction. It's a very custom job, and it would probably cost tens of thousands of dollars at a minimum. Apparently, there were three of these ever made, and also, we don't know where any of these prisms are today.
And that means that I'm never going to get to answer this burning question I have. Is sodium vapor better than green screen? The science, the physics, they all tell me it is. But because the prisms have been lost to time, I'm never going to get to realize my dream of a clown getting married on Mars. And then one day, I got a message from Paul Dubevic. He had done what I thought was impossible. He had recreated Disney's magic prism, and he needed somebody to test it out. This will be the first test of the sodium vapor process in over 30 years.
Well, I guess this is like...
So to me, that's really just because I want to add commentary so I don't get accused of plagiarism, Harris. Anyway, fucking, I hate H Bomber guy. I don't get it. He's British. I've realized that if you have an accent, Americans fawn over it.
Well, yeah, that's pretty standard.
It's like my mom told me once, you can tell me anything you want, just tell me it's an accent. You know, and like one time I was in downtown, I was in, where the hell was I? I was at Fashion Valley in like San Diego, and I decided to put on an accent, right? Put on a British accent. And I went up to this girl. I was like ordering lunch or something. And I was like, "It's like, oh, hello. How are you today?" And she's like, oh, I love your accent. Where are you from? Oh, you know, it's London. It's fine. Yeah, I've only been here a little bit, but I really like London. It. As well, what? She doesn't fucking know. She doesn't know. I mean, if I had a Cockney accent.
She should have been like Manchester. Do a little more. A little more creative.
Leicester could have been like Leicester, right? I'm like in my brain, I'm like, what the fuck are the goddamn fucking what's the map from Assassin's Creed Valhalla? Like Leicester, what like this? Because you're in London.
Where
you're
Thor's
in.
From?
It's just, yeah. It's funny. I mean, like, she was interested, and then I had to show her my ID, and I was like, oh, I live in Lakeside. You know, and she's like, whatever, you know. Anyway.
Well, you can still have an accent and live in the States.
Yeah, no, I know. But apparently, according to conservatives, that's really a bad idea. They think that's communism right there.
Really?
In California, they allowed undocumented immigrants to get driver's licenses. And people are furious about it. Because people think that means they can vote. And I'm like, you don't even know how voting works then, do you? Like, you can vote. Like, here's the thing. Like, there's a difference between your vote, you voting, and your vote being counted. You know, like, there really is. Like, there really is a difference. You know, well, it's a 1-2 process. And if you do one, and you're lying, it's a high probability you're going to get caught. And then that's where they busted people that were predominantly Trump supporters that were voting illegally. I think it's probably 99% of the voter fraud that happened during the 2020 election was, you know, fucking conservatives. Which seems about right.
Yeah, that seems about right. You know, a while ago, you're talking about TikTok tonight. And a while ago, I said TikTok is like the depths of hell or something like that. And you're like, you should come on and talk about that. I wanted to kind of follow up on that.
Yeah.
Okay, this is an old man like talking, so everyone knows. Like, I'm the same age as Matt. Like, we're both old men, so this makes it very clear.
Whatever, man. I only look old.
Dude, I don't think I look old either, but ever since I've had kids, I feel like I've aged like 20 years in like two.
Yeah.
You know, so it's crazy. Okay, listen. I'm an old man, you know. I never got into like Vine or that shit, you know. All my friends and my wife got really into it back in the day. And when TikTok came on, I was like, it's another Vine. And, you know, because I have the YouTube channel, the Comic Binge and everything that I'm trying to, like, you know, promote and everything, you know, do that whole vibe. You know what it is, Matt. You know how it is.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay, I need to get TikTok. I need to get on with the kids and get into it. And I like doing little skits. And I have some on there. And I still want to do more. I have no time. All my Gen Z nephews like ripped me to shreds on him, but I don't care. I think they're really fun. But I kind of started like just looking at it, trying to understand. Like, I understood TikTok, but like I just started like kind of like getting more familiar with it. Like, what exactly can you do on TikTok opposed to other places? And I just one night, this is so weird. Okay, and everyone who probably already knows this is probably like, yeah, old man, shut the hell up. But Matt, this is hear me out on this. So, you know, I'm in bed and I'm just kind of like, whatever, I'm just dinking around on TikTok. And I discovered like people going live at night and just all interacting in different places. And people it's bonkers to me. It was a Saturday night and I'm like, this is a different universe where everyone's just in front of a phone answering questions. Just while they're like either like going to before they go out to like drink and dance or whatever, or like when they're like one person, because I'm, you know, we're West Coast, right? So there's like a ton of East Coasters over there, like 1 a.m. like completely wasted, just barely functional as human beings on TikTok. And then there's one person, and because everyone, they must have some kind of following. Like one, like just one girl, like must have been 20 years old or something like that. It's basically sleeping.
Wait, you've never seen the sleeping?
No, I've never seen. Like,
oh man, sleeping. The sleeping streams have been around forever. It's the sleeping streams are largely designed to like make money because people will they'll pay you. Like, you go to sleep and all of a sudden it's just like, you know, your like people will be,
yeah
they'll start like person. they'll donate money, and that money that they donate will end up going to, you know, whatever alert, right? Holy derail. Yeah, well, we're gonna, yeah you know, we're adding extra commentary because this could work on TikTok as well. I don't know. We're gonna give
holy derail. I told you. We gotta talk about it because you're looking for stuff to talk about. I want to talk about TikTok, but you can kind of get the hell off too. I have no problem doing that either.
No. It's also, but I mean, well, no. He was asking me last night to watch it, so it's. We'll get to.
Oh,
it.
Oh, my bad. My friend. I apologize.
No. It's all right. I mean, like, well, let me see here. I'm looking up this here. I'll bring it up. So I got TikTok live right here. Here's some guy. It's muted. But like, here's this guy talking about like the best horror movie and shit. Oh, okay.
Can you even consider the mega horror film?
We lost him for a hot second. We'll see if he can come back on in. I don't quite know. But, you know, I'm just looking to see anything weird on TikTok Live. I think, weren't we looking at this a while back or some shit? Is this all that's on live right now?
I like the character design, but the acting was made for TV, so probably why.
You may want to come back out. Go in and come back out.
It's been a pretty
good
scene.
Smoke it!
Pinky.
Didn't I say to get that rose out of here?
I don't know what the hell this lady's about. All right.
I have some lineup.
Slay gang? Okay.
Tyrone, again.
Lexus, Chanel, Jennifer, January, Chloe, Gyro, Timmy, Anderson. Let's go, chat. Chat, follow me on TikTok if you want me to sing your name. Follow me on TikTok. Like and share my latest post on TikTok and write your name in the comments. We're about to sing those names right now. Let's go. Go put your name in. Let's get it. Thank you all for the gifts, chat. Thank you all for the gifts. We're finna sing those names now. Here we go.
Brooklyn, Jocelyn, Lexani and Denise, Lena, Kiki, Josiah, Jakayla, Harmony, Tyrone, Halo, Marie, Corin, Jonathan, and Timothy.
All right. That's not bad. Oh, God.
Yeah, they're getting used to Peach.
Oh, no.
Hey, Grinty.
Oh. Hey, girl. Hey. So, how's everyone doing? What's new? What's new?
The Green Queen.
Green Queen Machine. Know what I mean?
Hey, girl.
Hey, girl. Hey, how's it going?
Grinchy, you look beautiful.
Thank you.
What do you think of the new dander dart?
Of course, there has to be another dander dart. Like,
this
I knew I was sniffling more for a reason. Like,
okay, so like this lady right here.
All that cat hair, I can't take it.
She sounds
Chad Grinty.
The voices sound too similar. Yeah. Here we go. Dude playing GTA. Driving on the wrong side of the road, man. What you doing, man? What you doing? Goal is 100,000 likes.
GRX, you can suck a dick. Everybody in the server don't know how to RP. That's the thing.
Always in an RP server.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Come on, words, Chad. Come on, words.
Oh no. What is this?
Shorty bad in the mind. Find a way that she can make it through the night. Traumatized, but she keep it deep inside. Everybody in the comments just rap for me to life. I'm feeling wide, triple nine. I pull a hopper on his block, dominate design. I'm posting with the gang, whole gang outside. Can't maintain the things that's in the mind. I couldn't try just to make it.
Alright, see, now I went to TikTok Live.
Really, I pull a hopper on, never check the.
Never!
So, are you still there?
I've never been in the same boat with this man, bro.
Hold on. Are you there? Are you there? Wait. I hear myself.
Chat out. Fuck real shit.
Brother,
I love
my
brother.
What is happening?
Damn,
okay.
Bro,
yeah. He's having some problems. Having some big old problems. All right. Random girl. Hot tub screaming. Okay. Like I haven't muted. I don't even know how you're hearing it.
When, like, it's not anything like me.
That's 650 like, people watching this girl live. 3.5 hours she's been in that hot tub. So that's a long time to be in that fucking hot tub.
But I also like,
right? Like she's just gonna come out completely clean.
Like, not, I don't know,
you know?
Like mentally.
It's just gonna make her Lady Majora look like a fucking California raisin.
Anyway. All right, Herman. We can like definitely. You may want to. Are you coming on your phone or are you coming in the computer? Or I don't know how you're doing it.
A little bit more spicy.
We'll figure it out. But in the meantime, I don't know what's happening. People, I mean, like people are able to do some of this shit now with OBS and really build out their setups, which is nice. I don't have access. Homie's playing guitar. Matt going Zoomer on us? Not really. I find live streaming interesting. These people look, man. If I could do fucking Boulder talk on goddamn TikTok and probably get more people watching. I mean, like right now, I've got 90 people on Twitter watching, and I've got 37 on YouTube, which is really fucking funny.
Matt, may I ask you something?
Yeah.
So here's the thing. So I wanted to comment. Sorry, my AirPods went nuts. That's why I had to. Something went crazy with me with them. Sure. And I apologize. So Here's the deal: that when I was talking about when I'm on that one night, I'm just watching it, and as we're just kind of glancing through this, I just saw a different, complete world of streaming, like you're saying, right? And it's fascinating. It was fascinating, but it also felt like a different universe, a different dimension that I was in. Because that person that said that was sleeping, it wasn't like even they were sleeping for a stream. It's like they were half awake, trying to stay awake, answering people's questions while they were almost falling asleep. It was just like, I'm like, what is the point of this? It was almost like people are so addicted to attention. Like they're just like going to literally fall asleep to people asking them questions for like their own self-importance. And like it was just so random seeing so many different, and it wasn't just like, you know, one age group either, Matt. It was all over the place. I was shocked. And that's why it was just a wild, wild thing. Cause right now you're having a bunch of random people doing their own thing, whatever. But like on Saturday night when you got like, you know, the sleep in the next day and you got, you know, whatever, it's crazy. It was just a different universe, man.
I mean, you got to remember, like when it comes to, I mean, you could argue like the creator economy or whatever. I really am not a huge fan of that term, but
sure.
In many ways, when they talk about the creator economy, what they're talking about is stuff like that, where like attention is what you need to get, right? Because attention means more eyeballs. It means ultimately more money. But so people will do it, and they try to do it the fastest way that they can. Because it's the idea of like slow grinding it when you're putting in so much effort in the front end, it can burn people out. Like this shit is not for like the faint of heart.
Oh, I know. Trust me. Yeah.
It's really not. Like I'm sitting there like, man, like I want to do like, I enjoy mostly just talking with people, which is why I just kind of want to do this whole BTR thing. But it's just, I'll go, am I thinking like, man, maybe I should do more Hollywood After Dark? And I'm like, there's stuff I do want to talk about, but it's also like, how much of it do I want to commit? And like, how's my timing to be able to get shit done? Because, you know, I'm fucking working full time. So it's like, you know.
And that's one thing that, you know, I, as someone who's been podcasting, you know, steadily since 2011, and, you know, and now just got into the YouTube game. And I have a big like punk rock background, you know. I did a lot of music back in the day, and as someone who we've talked about on DMs, right? And it's like you gotta do what you love, but at the same time, you know, you gotta whatever's worth your while. And it's so fascinating you talk about the grind and how people on TikTok and all these people everyone wants to get there as soon as possible. And let me be very frank. I totally get it. We all want that. That's human nature. It's, you know, instant gratification, like, right? And even now, as I do in the comic binge, it's like, I love doing it. I'll never stop doing it, I don't think, for a long, long time, I foresee. I mean, maybe I'll probably stop next month and be like, screw this. No, but like, the thing is, it does come to a point where it's just, the grind it's a grind. And when you don't get, you know, it's like when you don't break through the wall, and this, I always use music as like as my way to try to explain this. And when people try to explain it to me back in the day, it all made sense. And like with music, when you're writing songs and whatnot, we're not using AI, Matt.
What? Listen, man. Listen. All right. My artificially created songs are just that. They're very artificial.
I know. I'm giving you a hard time. I don't really care. Because to me, this is a whole different conversation. But AI has its pros and cons, and I whatever. But I digress. But the thing about, you know, the producer I worked with for a long time, a good friend of mine, I don't talk anymore. He just had a baby. Congrats, Corey. He always talked about how music is just like, as you're just writing and working on and trying to progress, it's like you keep hitting that wall and you eventually break through and you're like, oh my God, yes, you know, creatively. And anything creative in art, you can relate to that in some way, right?
Yeah.
The problem is when you're making content is you just hit that wall and you never break through, it feels like. And you just feel like, and you're tired of just putting your body on that line, and because nothing breaks through, you're just like, fuck it, you know? And that's the thing. That's what sucks. And I think that's what you got. There's people out there on TikTok who are trying to like get there as fast as they can. And there's pros and cons to everything. But for me, it's hard. It's, you know, you have all these different things you want to do. You have little time, and it's just, you know, nothing, you can't predict what's going to break out. You know, that's why we talked a lot about this. You know, I tell people on X, formerly Twitter, all the time when I can, I'm like, you know what, go start your thing, do it. You love it, and be consistent. And until it doesn't become fun anymore, stop doing it. But it does. I mean, I'd be lying to say it doesn't like bum me out sometimes. I'm like, well, I wish like my YouTube channel had more interaction. I saw it like, not, I'm not asking for like, you know, next level popularity, but if I could get some growth, I'd be pretty stoked. It's even steady, it's like little steady growth, but I don't even have that. And it becomes a bummer, you know, after a while. But at the same time, I love what I do. So I'm like, eh, whatever, I'll just keep doing it and see what happens. I mean, probably nothing will ever happen. That's fine.
Well, but I think, a lot of it is a grind, but you also have to, like there is a certain amount of luck that happens with it, right? Certain amount Absolutely. Of things, yeah. You know, I mean, Jess here is saying VTubers are becoming more mainstream. I mean, that's if you like VTubers. I don't. It's not that like I have anything against, like, what people have to understand is like I tend to listen to most of the content that I watch. So like a VTuber would Absolutely. Just be, is like yeah. way more distracting. Like even the Deep Lore episode I put out today, it's audio. I had some moving parts in the background. But I'm not going to edit any content because like it doesn't matter. I'm not trying to build that out. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
I don't care. I'm not trying to sit there and be like, you know, I'm going to have like a 3-hour video that's going to have like hardcore editing. Like, fuck you. I don't have time for that.
Yeah.
And so really, but again, a lot of it is just like, you know, it's just figuring it out. Like, for example, like I like to respond to discussing film and culture crave on Twitter. I make about between 15 and 20 bucks every 2 weeks doing it. But it's like, you know, and I get like probably a couple million impressions, meaning people see my name, you know, and my posts like every week, you know, yeah. And yet it's like my follower count is not, it really ebbs and flows. Like it shot up to 20,900 yesterday. And then I checked today and it dropped down to like 20,887. A lot of them are
exactly.
Or they follow yeah. whatever, you know. Yeah, I know that there are VTuber podcasts. I'm just saying, I don't care if you're a VTuber. Like nothing about being a VTuber is interesting to me personally. I'm not gonna demoralize you from doing it or attack you for doing it. I just don't find like, it's again, like I don't have a like, you know, I'm getting more into anime. Like I really enjoyed Your Name. I need to watch some more stuff. All right. But a lot of the hardcore like ooh, type shit. And especially some of those fucking personalities I've seen some of those VTubers put on makes me want to fucking kill myself. It's just, it's not damn, interesting. Bro. No, it's true. It's like, I mean, it's like if you listen to some of those people talk and you're just, you know, and you're like, oh my God, I know it's a fucking act, but like, you know, like where's, like, I'm just going to suck start that shotgun. I'm just going to end it. Like might as well. But no, it is what it is. Also, Commandant here for 5. Thank you. The Tech Corridor Digital Rediscovered isn't AI, but it can boost AI learning performance. Well, we are going to get back to that. We just got detoured. That's okay.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
This is a marathon, not a sprint, like YouTube.
yeah, exactly. You know, and the thing is too, like, you know, I look at YouTube and everything, because like, I've talked about, you know, I have one day, well, I have a real legitimate, not now, because I don't want to get everyone mad at me, but one of these days we'll have to do a BTR, wherever, Hollywood After Dark, whatever the fuck, I don't care. But whatever we do it, I have an honest question. I talked to one of my best friends about a couple weeks ago. I was in San Francisco, and it was about filmmaking. And I would love to pick your brain about it, because it kind of involves AI, everything, to be honest. And just, well, I'll pitch my idea to you. We can talk about it, because I know dick about, you know, Hollywood as far as like movie making, and things like that. But I do know about the creative side in general, and how the ebbs and flows. So just one of these days, I like to talk about that. You know, but obviously not right now. But back onto like YouTube and whatnot, because YouTube is one of the reasons why I want to bring that up. And like TikTok and all these different things, it's like it's just very interesting to see where content creating and all that kind of is going into a social media. Even now, like I was talking to some people on a group chat that I'm on, and there someone was commenting about how, you know, 2,000 views on X, formerly Twitter, is not really a big of a deal. I'm like, well, it's not, but in a sense, but really you're planting seeds, you know, it's not, you know, think about commercials, right? Like wherever, even if people like see your name and whatever, it's like, they will eventually like learn to get to kind of know that your name is integrated with something. Even if they don't necessarily are seeking you out initially, if you keep seeing their name, it's like commercials, right? It's like when people put in like freaking it's a bad analogy, toilet paper commercials, you know, they're not expecting you to be like, I gotta go buy toilet paper right now. I mean, there is some of it's right there, but I mean, like, some of it's subliminal to a point of like, you know, if you keep seeing the same Charmin commercial with those cute little teddy bears, whatever it is, or those bears, you're gonna think like, when you're out, you know, grocery shopping, like, well, I ain't wet my butt tonight, I better get some, oh yeah, that one thing. It's just, it's ingrained in you, right? That's the whole point of commercials and things like that. It's like that too. That's why I'm always trying to get out there and hate to abuse the algorithm, but that's what it is. You have to get out there, because it's, people don't, if they don't know and they can find you, they're not gonna seek me out personally. Like, that Paul Herman guy is pretty rad, I'm gonna go find him. Like, no one gives a shit about me. You know, I had to put myself out there. So it really is about just being a slave to the whatever algorithm it is, which just sucks. I hate it, but it's the reality, right? But it is, there's a method to it, right, too. So,
well, I mean, a lot of it is, okay, so the way it works largely is, you know, I've watched a bunch of these, you know, sure, like these YouTube gurus over the years, and I've gone to like Vid Summit, and I've gone to like the YouTube business side of VidCon, and I've spent a lot of money, right, to be in the situation I'm in right now. Really, it's kind of funny how much I've spent. But one of the things I learned is, like, you know, they tell you, like, well, you got to identify your niche, and then it's like, never leave your niche, which is actually true for your channel. Like, if you want to have multiple niches, then you've got to have multiple channels. And that's just for the way that, that's just for what YouTube does in regards to cataloging everything. You know, it's like, I started doing Podio commentary, made it its own channel. Fuck, I can't get shit for views over there. So I'm probably just going to, like, if I don't do any more Hollywood After Dark, I might just start moving all those back over, and then just specifically having Three Buck Theater just be a review channel and like not worry about it, because I don't see much of a need anymore. It's like, I still want to talk about like what's going on in the industry, but because I'm working so many hours, I just can't, you know, stream about it. And then it's like, but I only have 3 days off in a row. You know, so if I stream on my days off, I can't do the normal, you know, like Monday to Friday or Sunday to Thursday shit, you know, so it's difficult.
You know, for me, like your Podio commentaries, I always say, like, you should just put it on Hollywood and just put it as a subgenre on, because it's all about movies and, you know.
Yeah, I know. Anyway. It's just, it's like the thing, one of the reasons why I did that is because in many ways, the YouTube algorithm doesn't recommend, like, you know, the audience is, like, I looked up today, like, what the audience is watching, and they're watching Grace Randolph, they're watching John Campia, they're watching things like that. And it's like, no, it's because predominantly
I talk about movie news, right? And so right. movie people will watch other movie people. And the truth is, like, I don't watch, like, anybody really talk about movie stuff anymore. And a lot of that has to do with the fact that it's just, like, I'm so burnt out by, like, by the nonsense of it. And it's, like, I was talking about this with a customer the other night at work, and I'm just, like, there's no left-wing billionaire that's funding the fight to take the fight to these guys, right? You know, to take the fight to these people. And that's a big problem.
Matt, I want to ask something, because I know you know a lot about this business, because you've been in for like a long time, 10 years, whatever. I think you had said the other day. I didn't know how much research, 12. How much, 12. Excuse me, Matt. I'm sorry.
Long time.
I know. I hear you.
Let me die.
Stop. So here's my thing. I want to ask you this, because I think this is what, I find this a fascinating. I really do. Because, again, I come from such a punk rock, like, just kind of do whatever, you know, I have no idea what the hell it is, do what you love, kind of just put your head down to the grindstone. But I'm curious what your opinion of this would be, because right now the algorithm is feeding like a niche thing. Do you think that there'll be a time when someone could transcend someone's or a group of people or whatever, right, could transcend this thing where they're able to do multiple things on their channel rather than be a niche? Or is it possible, or is YouTube going to be pretty much like, no, this is the way, the truth, and the life, nothing will go through this way but us? Or do you think it's possible that someone could trump, for a better lack of a better term, that trend, and maybe make it be a little more diverse?
Can you give me like an example of what you might be thinking?
Like for yourself. Like, for instance, like you said that yourself, like, well, everyone, it's either like you're either Grace Randolph or John Campia or nothing, like in that realm. You can't really do both, or kind of do like more of like what you want to do with patio commentaries and things like that. You know, it's, you know, because you said like part of it's the algorithm. So my question is, do you think that, you know, will the algorithm be more diversified in a sense of like, that someone like yourself or someone who is out there could do multiple things for their channel and not be regulated because of like the way it's shooting or way it gives out its information, like, so they have to be like only a one trick pony kind of a thing, so to speak?
Yeah, so the way that I see it is like, you know, like we're kind of in this weird age of YouTube at the moment where like extravagance is what's going to get the most attention, right? Extravagance, or like,
yes,
you know, in the mainstream part of it, like Mr. Beast has, for lack of a better sentiment, destroyed YouTube, right? Like, YouTube will never be the same again with Mr. Beast around, right? What I mean by that is like, he commands so much attention and he's got so much backing. And his videos, you know, they have to keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Like, I don't mean this to be mean or to say that I want to see this or whatever, but I was listening to an interview with him recently, and this is his entire life. And the problem with it, though, is that it's impacting parts of his actual relationships. It's, he can't have, you know, his girlfriend, I don't know if he has one anymore. Like, he's completely working all the time, and all he thinks about is YouTube. And I understand that mentality, but I understand also like how detrimental it is, how fundamentally detrimental it is, and how much it can, like, you know, it can really fuck with you. And so if something happens where, like, let's say all of a sudden the audience turns on Mr. Beast, or the YouTube stops promoting him for whatever reason.
Sure.
No. I would not be surprised in the slightest if we got wind that either he admitted himself to a mental institution or he killed himself, because like, that is how far, and I'm talking the latter is probably more realistic than the former. Like, if they can catch him beforehand, then the former will happen. But if he's by himself and he feels all is lost and whatever, like, that's what he would just do that. And again, I don't want to see that, nor am I trying to advocate for it or whatever. I would much prefer him to get help. But the problem when it comes to this sort of thing is, the larger you get, the more responsibility you have to your audience. And then when you have more responsibility to your audience, in many ways, you have to then compete against yourself
in order to make the content more viable for the audience rather than just being happy with what you have and building that community. It's like, I understand that I will probably never, ever get back to where I was in 2018 before everything went to shit. All right. I'm okay with that. I don't need that. I don't need that kind of like, you know, whatever. I wasn't happy doing it. Oh, we lost him again. Okay. Well, he's coming back in. We'll figure that out there. Okay. All right. Hold on. Command Unit here for five. Thank you, buddy. Says over 90% of YouTubers are female. There are a lot of them mostly because it protects her real life identity and is low maintenance and no need for makeup. I mean, listen, the thing is the way I view it is that, like makeup channels are like one of the worst things on YouTube. I think that destroys, self-confidence that women have. So I understand why a lot of female VTubers might want to look like that, because then it takes away all expectations for what they actually look like. And I think that's kind of sad because, you know, I'm just saying, it's like, you know, there's a lot of like Instagram has destroyed the way young girls look at their bodies. You know, it's promoted the concept of like, you have to be fit and attractive and styled and, you know, fashioned up, when like these people get a lot of clothing given to them by retailers that cost thousands of dollars in the store to wear for these ads. They get all their makeup for free, and then they have an editor go in and fucking Photoshop everything, you know, and to give the false reality to these young girls. You want my honest opinion? Ban Instagram. Don't ban TikTok. Ban Instagram.
Yeah, you know, you brought up some really good points there, and you're right. I think so many things, we're right in this really weird way, world of YouTube, and so many different like mediums are in a very weird state because of streaming is not going exactly the way everyone thought it was going to. All these big level, you know, even Bob Iger, you know, who thought like streaming's gonna be, it's the only future, and that kind of went crashing down on them. And you know, there's a lot of weirdness going on outside of just the art forms of you know, corporate America, you know, everything. But it is fascinating to see where we're at, because I do feel like we're in a transitionary period for so many different mediums, like even for films, for comics, for TV, for, you know, and I think for YouTube and things like that. There's almost feels like we're about to hit a transition period, Matt, and no one can really predict it, because it can go a million different ways. And I feel like it's just, we're in this really weird state where it's about to be, I always compare it to like, it feels like we're in the 70s. Like if you want to compare the eras, it feels like now we're in like the 70s, where like we're coming out of like weirdness. We're coming out of like just these weird eras, but like things are kind of like evolving a little bit, but kind of slowly. And then what happened in the 80s, right? Like the 80s, just things went nuts and evolved a lot, and things got, you know, decadence, you know, there was a lot of corruption and debauchery and just overall in the entire 80s, and the 90s paid for it in a lot of ways. but you know what I'm saying though, feels like that's what we're doing now, out of COVID and out of you know, these mini recessions you had, inflation. It feels like that's what the 70s had a lot of, because of, you know, the wars and everything and whatnot. I mean, it's not one for one, obviously, but you get what I'm saying. There's, for me, it has that feeling of like things are kind of like not, it was unsettled in the 70s, and the 80s happened, and then things just went crazy. And it feels like that's what we're about to hit. Like this point of like, because I think the 80s is one of the best decades of all time. Maybe I'm biased because I was born in the 80s, and you know, I love the,
well, I mean, the 80s, you know. But the 80s is like the move from analog to digital, right? Exactly. Like that's the decade where that happened. And, you know, I mean, obviously, you know, the 90s kind of really accelerated that, because there's always a half-life on new technology. You know what I mean? Process always halves. And so as technology gets faster, especially now with the AI and everything, what we're going to see in the next couple of years is going to be buck fucking wild. So we might be in that new phase, you know, fucking 30, 40 years post, uh, post the 80s. Now we're 40 years in the 80s at this point, because I'm 42. God, no. I was born 42. In 82. I'm now 42. You
same,
know,
same.
So
yeah,
it's
I'm only
like
2 months older than you are.
Oh, okay. Oh, well, yeah. It's fun, ain't it? Right. Woo. Yeah. Yeah. My daughter today, she goes, "You're 24. And I'm like, "Fuck, I wish."
Oh, God. You know,
I'm like, she's like, "You wish you were 24? And I'm all like, "Yeah."
Well,
yeah,
I
had freedom at 24.
No, I don't. I'll say it right now. In my early 20s and mid 20s, it's fun to be younger and have like no responsibility. But then I think about having no money and being like, because I mean, I've worked hard for, my wife and I both have worked hard for what we have here. So like, I'm like, no, I'm good. Like, I mean, I wish I had like, you know, I had more life to live, I guess, instead of 24 than 42. But where I'm at now, I'm like, no, pretty good. I'm good with that.
Well, you know, I would argue, the way I look at it is, as much as there are things that I regret that I would love to change or go back or do differently,
sure.
If I did that, I wouldn't have my kids.
Exactly.
You know, so it's like, I mean, would I have kids? Sure, maybe. But would I have my specific daughters? No. And I don't want to change that. I don't want to change that for the fucking world.
Well,
so
I can tell you right now, someone I adopted my daughter, and you know, it is the life I led to get to this point. Like I literally would never change anything, even though there was a lot of hellish years to get to her, to get to my daughter, basically. I'll just be very, very vague on that. Very hellish years before I had my daughter. And my wife would be the first to say, like, I would not want to relive those ever, but if it meant for my daughter, yes. So yeah, I mean, it's, I, you know, you have to go through things in life, and sometimes I look back and go, I wish I wouldn't have to go through that, but you know what, I wouldn't trade her in for anything. So I totally, trust me, totally get it. So
exactly.
I'm going to head out, but I always really appreciate it. I can just like say, hey, I want to jump on. You always let me on. It's really appreciative. Thank you very much.
Sure.
Really
no, that. I enjoy it. And then we're meeting up on Saturday, right?
Yeah. I'm still planning on doing that. And that's, okay. I don't want to reveal. I want people to come up and beat the crap out of us, but I'll just.
No, this is Olympia. They're fucking pussies. You know, all right. But if you were like, yo, let's bomb up the 99 to fucking Aurora. And then, you know, like do something there. There's pimps and hoes everywhere, like legit.
Bro, hey, listen. I used to work in Shoreline, and I used to live in South Seattle. So,
oh, okay. I took a family of like 10 people home yesterday, and then like they were like literally like right off 99, like right in Shoreline Edmonds area. And I'm just like, I got time to kill before my next pickup. So
no.
I'm just going to troll down fucking 99 all the way back. And I saw like three or four hookers out, and I was laughing.
Okay. Hold on. I got to tell you this. I got to stop you only because you're only been doing this job less than a year, just over a year.
6 months. 6 months I'm at this job.
Okay. Homie, speak from experience. Wait till it gets warmer.
Oh yeah, no, it's gonna. I get that.
It's about to get even more crazy.
I know. I go up that way all the time, so it's just kind of. I'm like just laughing because I'm just like,
it's crazy.
It's still such a shock to me, and I actually Googled it last night. I'm like, so why is it legal? And it's just. It turns out that it's not legal per se, but they decriminalize sex work in Seattle. And so there's no chance that the hookers are going to get busted, but the Johns will get busted.
Yeah, they'll get busted.
And
yeah.
They also closed down a couple of those hotels because, like, I noticed that all the girls are right next to this one, I don't want to say seedy looking motel, but yeah. I'm all like, there's the hotel. Okay. Cause I'm just trying to understand the logistics of it in my brain. Cause I just like to figure things out. So I'm just like, what would be the, like, what is the catalyst for this? Where do they go? And like, is there a pimp right behind the corner that we don't know about yet? Like all those little things. And it's just
it's
like,
crazy.
But it's so weird to me because I've never seen it before. So I'm always just so super confused by the whole process.
Know, when I was driving from South Seattle to Shoreline, you know, every day, I didn't really even notice it until one day, it was during the summer when I was telling you about, wait till it gets warmer. They come out, they're everywhere, literally everywhere. I'd be driving it. Like I get up early. And I'd be getting there, I'd be driving from like 6:30 in the morning and I'd see him out like by, do you know where the IHOP is in North Seattle?
I'm sure I've passed by it.
Yeah, the Meridian Theater. It's basically like, I'm trying to think of like your cross street. It's like, anyway, if you're on 99, if you're going up, going north, and you're going to go past like an IHOP, the old Meridian Theater. I don't think it's there anymore. And like,
I'm sure I've passed it because I've taken it from Linwood all the way back down to the airport. So,
oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
I had to because of how bad traffic was. Like that was the fastest route. Yeah.
No, trust me. But anyway, one day it was probably 6:15, 6:30, and there's so many of them out, just like all like just from the night before, chilling out everywhere. And I'm like, it didn't really hit me. I'm like, oh my God. This is not them waking up. This is them from the night before. And they're just hanging out, and it's just like, oh my, it's sad, man. It honestly bums me out.
It's kind of, it's just like, it's such a shocker because, like, for me, it was like, I've just never seen it in that capacity before. So I was very much like, oh shit. But then you're also like looking at the logistics of it, like, how is it safe? Are they safe? Are they clean? You know, like, is people being protected? Yeah. Like, so there's all these, and believe me, guys, it's not like I'm like, hey, I want to go do that because I don't.
Oh, God, no.
Want to. But it's just like it's something like it's a different part of society like I've never seen. And that's very taboo. But here it's out in public display. So you're just kind of shocked by it. Right. But
I'll hit you up on Saturday. I think you're still going to be we're going to the fair that day. So it's like I'm going to be going basically by myself, then driving up, meeting with my family in Tacoma. To hit the Puyallup Fair, so we'll see.
Oh, does that start this?
Yeah, homie.
I thought that was until the end of summer.
Or it's some fair. My wife got tickets for.
Oh no, there's a parade. There's a parade happening, I think. Or did that already happen? I picked up some people that were like a couple blocks away from the fairgrounds in Puyallup. So I don't know. I drive at night, man. I drive at night, so I don't even know like what's going on half the time. Let's get me from point A to point B. And tip and cash, please. That's basically about where I'm at with it.
Yeah, exactly. Well, listen, I like I said, I'm still planning on coming down there. It's gonna be a long drive, but it's always fun. But I appreciate getting me on this show, and everyone, thanks for putting up with us. Talk to you later.
I'll see you later, buddy. Thank you. All right. Thank you very much, Paul, for coming on in. His name is Paul. I just had got his name wrong. I feel bad. All right. We got Maverick here for $10. Thank you so much, buddy. Sorry I didn't get to this sooner. Saying, I took my kid to a VTuber con last year. It was the first time as a parent that I truly didn't understand the appeal. People were taking pics with characters on a screen that were like really there. That's weird. I would feel weird if I did that. If my daughter was like, I want to go to a VTuber conference, I'd be like, no, you need Jesus. That's what's going to happen. You need Christ. Because otherwise, we're in some weird shit. Thank you for that. Also, command unit here for $5. Thank you. VTubers' avatars have provided people with image issues and other health problems. So while you can dislike individual VTubers, I have to defend the concept. I'm not like attacking the concept. I just think it's weird. Look, you do you, boo. Enjoy that shit. I get it. I have body image issues, all that stuff. Everyone does, you know? I prefer being off camera more than being on camera because I'm more comfortable when talking, but that's really about it. It's just weird for me. All right. Jess here for $5. Thank you. Says, what are your thoughts on the nuisance influencers or prank channels? I think they are far worse because they don't get consequences. I vehemently hate nuisance motherfuckers and prank channels, right? Like I've seen so many that were fucking just absolutely racist. And then like they get people going after them and they're like, yo, it's a prank, bro. It's a prank. You know? And you're like, you're going to get fucking wrecked, motherfucker. So I've seen that shit and I don't like that shit. I think that sometimes there's consequences. There was one guy recently who got, I think, a lifetime ban from Walt Disney World or something. Tyler something. Got busted. So there may not be consequences on the YouTube front, but there are definitely consequences. So thank you for that. All right. You felt so out of place there. Yeah, I would too. I would be too. What do you mean that's harsh? What do you mean that's harsh? What's harsh? I don't even know. You gotta tell me. Oh, no, wait, we're not doing that one. All right, let's go back to the Corridor Digital video that we were working on. Okay. Zap, yeah, DM it to me on Twitter, and if you can, if not, let me know, and then I can play it here. Yeah, that's fine. By the way, thank you for being a member. Appreciate that. All right. Oh, here we go.
Like our hello world of sodium vapor matting, we've got our color image and our sodium vapor image there.
There it is. Look at that.
That's the idea.
It's working.
The first thing you need are some sodium vapor lights. So thankfully, they still make the bulbs. Eventually, after we've had these on for 10 minutes, they'll start glowing that color.
I think it's working.
And then we've got a couple of LED lights here that are going to illuminate the after. Sodium vapor mats.
Woohoo.
Hey.
Pretty sweet.
How is this working? How did Paul Dubevic manage to resurrect Disney's lost prism? Well, with a deep understanding of the science of light and a little bit of creativity.
Thank you, Chaotic.
I'll do a beam splitter, but I'll just do a regular beam splitter like this beam splitter, and then we'll filter the light after it comes out of the prism.
Paul recreated the physics of the sodium vapor process, but he did it with all off-the-shelf components. Instead of a custom beam splitter, he used two filters. And instead of two strips of film, he just used two cameras.
Now, if you ever think your rigs are janky, they're all janky.
For the first time ever, my dreams are within my grasp.
Want to know what's within your grasp? A beautifully designed website, thanks to our sponsor, Squarespace. It's a story about a clown that's trying to get married.
I don't need to watch none of their sponsored shit.
You think so, though?
But good
Me?
For them.
What?
Look, I've heard big things about this magic crystal, okay? But this is ridiculous. That's impossible to key. Look at that. I hate to break it to you, but this video is going to be a disappointment.
JC, feel free to come on out.
It's my wedding day.
Oh my God. That would be difficult to key, wouldn't it?
It would. I forgot to mention that the clown's getting married on Mars, hence the need to replace the background.
Oh, of course, yeah. I think this is going to be fantastic.
Now, I suppose we should clean up the lighting.
Yeah, kill all of the full spectrum lighting.
We need that one covered.
Yeah.
I need to cover one of the skylights so that we don't have all this like daylight spill coming in. And my dress is like Marilyn Monroe-ing right now. Keep this side down. It's the best the clown can do.
So as you can see right now, we're spending a lot of time
well,
in these flags.
You can't drop the link directly in here. That's what I'm talking about.
We don't
about.
Want the sodium vapor light to be hitting JC at all, because then it's going to be basically turning her transparent.
So this is a spectral light meter. It tells you the spectrum of the light. For example, this light here, that shows it's LED lights. It's made out of red, green, and blue LEDs to make the color white. And I can also take it and put it in front of the sodium vapor lights. There is our sodium vapor spike at 589 nanometers. So let's see if there's any sodium vapor light hitting our subject. Mostly good, but if I look closely here, I can see a tiny little blip. See that tiny little blip of sodium vapor?
Yeah, science.
We're very close, but we're getting a little bit of side spill on her, and we're just cleaning that up here. If we're the first ones to do this in like 30 years, I want to do it right, you know?
It went down.
Nice.
That should be better.
Looks like we almost have a perfect mat. I guess the only thing left to do is to shoot it.
Maybe we should shoot.
Cool, go ahead and roll the cameras. Okay. Here we are on Mars. The clown is looking for the groom. Uh-oh, there's aliens behind you. Maybe turn around, wave at the aliens. I want to get one shot
myself actually pretty
as
cool.
Well. Wearing my green hoodie, which I refuse to take off.
And hopefully the sodium vapor process lets us do something.
Nico, I want to see you do some headbanging. I want you to throw that head around.
Yeah, give that a shot, Zap.
That would be the hardest green screen shot. That would be so hard to do on a green screen.
And cut. Dude, this is going to be as successful as Mary Poppins.
Oh my God, wow.
Paul's research has been super influential on me. To get to work with him on an experiment is super, super cool. I hope this works. All right, let's take a look at what we got. Here's what our color footage looks like. And if I look at the sodium vapor shot, wow, it looks pretty good. Let's see what happens if I take that and turn it into a black and white transparency mask. Wow. This should work really well. But before I try pulling a transparency key here, I need to also try this with green screen to do a true comparison to know if this is better.
I'm using all the tricks for perfect green screen that I've acquired over the years. Lights with a hint of green on them, lights on Jordan with a hint of magenta to cancel out the green spill from the green screen. I'm going to do my best to light this green screen and shoot it as good as I can. All right, hi, you're on Mars. Wave to us, the audience.
So we all know that sodium vapor should give scientifically better results. But green screen tools have had years and years and years to mature. I can start pulling in the thickness of that mat, but while the dress starts to come back, the veil now has these ugly lines. I can try to, you know, close the holes in the dress using a different tool here, but it patches up the holes in the veil. There's just no way to handle the range of greens here and for green screen tools to know what we want to keep and what we don't want to
keep. Yeah, I mean, that's... I mean, they knew that was going to be the problem.
Destroyed.
You.
Actually, not that bad.
Be honest, did you do your best with the key?
I did. The issue is I can't get the transparency of the veil and like the slightly off-green dress. In fact, the only way you could do a shot like this is to go in and
yeah, I knew about the Vaseline on the camera for Luke Speeder.
Different solutions to the image. If the sodium vapor process is superior, it won't have any of these issues. All right, so it's time to try the sodium vapor process. Do the composite and see if it works. Here we have JC, and here we have our background, right? And the way we're going to do this actually mirrors the way they did it on film back in the day. So the thing is, if you just take two pieces of film and you layer them over each other, you end up with a double exposure. You need something called a holdout mat that leaves a hole for you to simply add your other image on top. So we're gonna take our background and we're gonna subtract the mat. We're gonna take our foreground and we're gonna subtract everything that isn't the mat. Now we take our background and our foreground and we simply add them together.
Honestly, I'm really excited to see this because it felt like we were doing one of the coolest, most high-tech things we've ever done. And I would love for this to pay off.
Here are the results, and I'll let you guys be the judge.
Whoa! Wow. That's wild.
Dude, it's Mary Poppins.
This is amazing.
It's incredible.
Wow.
Oh, no, you dog. Water. He's drinking water on Mars. This is my favorite one. The water is just such a flex.
Check out the motion blur.
Oh, the hands. Oh.
Wow.
The motion blur drops the color exposure correctly on the background right there. Turns it red.
Oh, correct math. Oh my God, it's so good.
Dude, those little tiny hairs on top. Oh my God.
I didn't have to do any work.
You didn't have to tweak your like white clip, black clip.
I hate that.
De-spill bias.
No, there's no spill.
What about your edge feather?
No edge feather, no de-spill, no messing with gamma of your mat, no thresholds, no restoring fringe, no cleaning the blacks, no cleaning the whites, nothing.
Just turn it on.
Just turn it on.
Wow.
Good job.
Wow.
That is amazing.
That's pretty awesome.
I'm Mary Poppins, y'all.
So I just got the opinion of everybody at Corridor, but I need to get the opinion that actually really matters.
Oh, wow. You're zooming in on it. You are not afraid of your mat lines.
That was clearly exactly what needed to be filmed to show off this technique.
Exactly.
What about a volume? Couldn't you use a volume?
In today's age, when you can just go and shoot on a volume with an LED screen, is sodium vapor worth pursuing?
In practice, a lot of those in-camera backgrounds will get replaced.
So it seems like we're still in a world where we need to be able to cut out backgrounds and put people on new things.
Yeah, flexibility in post-production is incredibly valuable. One thing that you're noticing is like compositing tools are getting better because they're starting to have a bit of machine learning inside of them. Machine learning needs training data. The question is, where do you get all that training data? There is no perfect, easy compositing technique. And I thought this would be a good way to do it.
So sodium vapor is another one of those essential
steps. So machine learning is AI, by the way.
Having perfect transparency for compositing and visual effects then.
Absolutely, it is the gold standard, the yellow standard.
Well, Paul, thank you once again for joining us here on the Corridor channel. If you like these deep dives into
all right, like legit, that was pretty cool. Like that was pretty dope. You got, I mean, like they were able to use like recreate some old tech that made green screen better than what green screen is. That's pretty crazy. But then you've also got the, you know, the issue, with what's it called, you know. Like it's old technology, but they could find a way to make it new, right? They could find a way to make it a thing that could work out. All right. I think it'd be pretty cool to see. I think that's pretty dope. Hold on. Okay. There we go. All right, Zap. I got your thing here. Thank you. Thank you for messaging me. Just as an FYI, just because the thing, I saw you put the friend request in. I'm just not going to accept it. It's nothing against you. I keep that private. So, but you can message me on there, but it's like, I probably won't like add anyone. I just don't add people. Again, nothing personal. It's just, I got to keep some stuff private. So, all right, here is a big fart at church. Okay, I don't know what the fuck this is. All right, here we go. Big fart at church. What the fuck? Oh, god damn it. I did it again. Son of a bitch. This is what happens when I fucking put my thing in front of it. All right. I'm sorry, guys. There we go. I did it again. Yeah. God damn it.
Oh, shit.
So, I don't believe that was really done. That was a sound effect fart. Like, it could be like a fart machine, but the fact that like no one responded, like no one even moved when the sound went off, tells me that it was all done after, like that it was all done after the fact is what I think happened. If I'm being perfectly honest here, folks, it's still farts are funny. Don't get me wrong. Farts are hysterically funny because of all that. But yeah, you can tell some people add that stuff in down the road, right? Or they just add that shit in afterward, and you know, and sometimes it ends up getting clipped pretty well. You know, it can work together if you can find a way to make it work. But unfortunately, it doesn't always have that particular vibe to it. So, especially at a religious event. Yeah. If you could do it at a religious event. They're always kind of fun to mess with people on, to be fair. You know, you gotta enjoy it, folks. It's just where it is. So I don't really have much else to talk about tonight. Did I miss anything here? Anyone got any final comments? I'm not going to go for like much longer. It's 11:30. I do have to get the kid to school tomorrow. This morning was definitely a bit on the rough side. And everything. So, let me see. Do we have anything else going on? I'm just kind of scrolling through the twits. Maybe there's something there. Was it Billy D. Williams said actors should be able to wear blackface? I would argue a lot of actors are probably in favor of blackface because you're acting, right? You're not real. Jonathan Majors not getting jail time. Yeah, man. Yeah, I figured that was going to happen, that he wasn't going to get it. Him getting a 52-week like anger management course basically just means that, you know, he's going to come back. Like, is he going to come back for Marvel? Nah, but like he'll get himself back into the groove of things. Absolutely. He'll get himself back out there. Yeah, that's crazy. It is crazy. But it is what it is. Rationally says, recently saw U.S. Marshals, and I forgot that Robert Downey Jr. was the antagonist. Yeah, man, fucking Wesley Snipes, dude. Wesley Snipes. Tommy Lee Jones back again. No Richard Kimball, unfortunately. I liked U.S. Marshals, though. I liked U.S. Marshals. Not as good as The Fugitive, because The Fugitive is The Fugitive, and that movie is fantastic. But U.S. Marshals was quite a bit of fun. Finally, RDJ can be the black man that I always knew he was. here we go. All right. Rationally for five. Thank you, buddy. Says, if Jonathan Majors wins his appeal, will Disney hire him back? That is the issue. And I don't know what the answer to that is going to be. In many ways, it's possible because like they're going to have to kind of at that point, like come to the terms that they, you know, he was convicted, and then that's why they fired him, but they held on, right? They held on for as long as they possibly could, you know, like, they definitely like did everything they could to try and make it something, to hold on. But it, you know, if he wins, they might. I think that's one of the reasons why they haven't said anything yet. You know what I mean? Like, I think that's one of the reasons why they haven't recast. There's not been anything specific that's been said. I mean, they're working on Fantastic Four, right? And like, there's obviously Doctor Doom. There's been talks about, there's been talks about, who is it? Doctor Doom, right? Oh no, they got the one woman from Ozark, Julia Garner, to be the Silver Surfer. right? And like that was a big deal. That was a big thing. So, oh wow! But just by the way, just the other day, somebody uploaded the entirety of Dune 2 to Twitter, and like I went looking for like the copy of it because the movie comes out like next month on home video, and the copy that's out right now of Dune 2 is pretty fucking phenomenal. Like I'm looking at it right now. It's like I'm looking at screenshots right now. So that's the thing. Yeah, the Disney protects its bands. Yeah. Your boss was arrested. That's the link. I didn't see a link. So why was your boss arrested? Was it stealing? That'd be kind of based, right?
Based.
I don't fucking know, man. I'm getting tired. Anyway. Yeah, all right. I think that's probably going to be it for tonight. Keep it a little bit shorter tonight. I do appreciate everybody. Probably will be on tomorrow. I think I got to talk to that one guy about whether or not we are going to do a watch along for In Search of my movie. That might be over on, you know, that might be over on what's it called? Three Bug Theater. Anyway, guys, yeah, it's been a damn day. But I do appreciate each and every one of you from the 153 watching between YouTube and Twitter. Thank you guys so much. I feel for you. And we will chit chat later. Have yourself a great night, everybody. Thank you again and peace out.